Hey y'all, welcome to What Chelsea Eats. Thank you so much for joining me today. I am coming to you today because I wanted to talk to you about, will prayer and fasting help you to shrink fibroids naturally? I want to tell you a little bit of a story about my experience with prayer and fasting and what it has to do with fibroids. The first time I had fibroids, I got diagnosed. I was devastated, like literally devastated, because I remember being a little girl, 12 years old, and my mother going into the hospital to have a hysterectomy. She had a grapefruit-sized fibroid on her uterus, and it was 1984, and there were really no options. The doctor said, you know, you've had your kids, your period is horrible, let's just give you a hysterectomy. When that doctor told me that I had fibroids, I went back to that time and I was just in shock. I couldn't believe it. I was totally and utterly just destroyed on the inside. I left the doctor's office and I immediately called my husband and told him what was going on. And I don't even think he really understood why I was so upset. And he probably didn't understand the degree of why I was upset, because he didn't have the history of what I was going through, because he didn't know what happened to my mother. I don't think I was thinking about this at the time, but I remember just after my mother had that hysterectomy, things started to go downhill for her health-wise. I do remember her being at home for 6 or 8 weeks or something after the surgery. And I remember her going back to work, and shortly after that, she started, like, she would get bronchitis all the time, and like just one thing after the other, she would get sicker and sicker. And then one time she started getting these liver spots all over her body, and they started itching, and like everything was just breaking down in her body. I don't want to go too much into that story about all the things that was happening to her. But in 1991, she ended up having to get a liver transplant because of all the sicknesses that she had after the hysterectomy. And I really believe that if you do not take care of yourself and you get a hysterectomy and you continue down the same path that you were headed down before you got the surgery. So I believe that if you do not deal with the root cause of why you got fibroids in the first place, and you go ahead and get surgery and you think that that's going to make you feel better, I'm telling you, the fibroids are like a little warning saying, there's something going wrong in the body. You need to work on healing your body, because if you just take out the uterus, it doesn't make the problem go away. The problem is still there, and it can manifest in other areas of your body. Like in my mother's case, she got liver disease. She got lung cancer. Like it just snowballed. Now, I don't know that it happens for everybody, but I'm telling you, if you have a condition like a female reproductive issue, it means that things are not right in your body. So I just want to give you food for thought there. So after I got the diagnosis, I went into a mode where I just ignored it. I just didn't pay attention. I didn't go back to the doctors. I didn't take she wanted to put me on Lupron to see if the fibroids would shrink. I mean, like, there was a whole lot of things that I just put my head in the sand and I ignored. But during that time, I started feeling worse and worse. And so what ended up happening is God started speaking to my heart saying, I want you to fast. I want you to fast. I want you to fast. And I just could not get away from it. And he wasn't talking about, let me go on a Daniel fast, which is essentially how I live right now, is a Daniel fast. But we'll go into the different types of fast there are. He wasn't talking about that. He was talking about a 40-day fast. And I thought when I was going to start the fast, it was going to be one of those fasts where I drank juice all day and I would have, you know, that to lean on for sustenance, you know, and that's not what he called me to. He called me to a 40-day fast where I drank one glass of juice a day, and that glass of juice was either a 16-ounce or a 32-ounce glass of juice. And at that time, which was 2010 when I finally was obedient and went on and fasted the way I was supposed to, I was just drinking carrot juice because I was busy, and it was the thing that was the easiest thing for me to do because I just couldn't wrap my mind around doing anything else, although I have been introduced to this lifestyle that I live now back in 2007. But because of food addiction, I was back and forth. I never really let my body heal completely and even went back to my old habits. And I think that's why I was actually ended up being diagnosed with fibroids at that time. I mean, a few years later. But at the time I started fasting, I had no idea when I fasted that the fibroids would go away. Before I started to fast, the fibroids were pronounced in my belly. I could feel them. Like I could tell that my uterus was swollen. As a matter of fact, I couldn't lay on my stomach because of the pressure. And I was bleeding a lot. I was bleeding a whole lot. God called me to this fast, and I know it was him because he carried me. And I fasted for 40 days and 40 nights on one glass of juice, and he sustained me. And I prayed every single morning for 1 hour because that was the time that I could pray. And at the time, my normal quiet time would be right here in this office where I have practiced my quiet time for a long period of time. I mean, since I lived in this house, I've lived here since 2007. I've prayed in this office. This is my personal space. But during the fast, I went inside of a closet and I literally prayed and poured my heart out and let God talk to me and let him heal me of some traumas that I had experienced throughout my life. And it was the most wonderful time that I had ever had with the Lord up until that point. And after the fast was over, the fibroids were gone. I didn't go to the doctor and get a scan. No, I didn't. But I'm telling you, I did not feel those fibroids. They weren't there. It was a miracle. After that, I did okay for a while with my eating, but then I went back to my old habits. And not only did I go back to my old habits, I went back with a vengeance. It was insane what I was doing to my body. It wasn't so much that I was gorging with food. It was the type of food that I was eating. And it was all the types of foods that I tell you all to avoid if you want to shrink fibroids naturally. And so there was still that root in my heart about food, like having food addiction and letting it control my life, my circumstances. And it's so easy to fall into it too, because society accepts food addiction just like it's not even an addiction unless you're 500 pounds. But there are thin people who have food addiction problems. There are, you know, food addiction doesn't discriminate. It's a demonic, and it needs to be rooted out so that you can be free. Although I have been healed of a lot of things during that 40-day fast, I think it opened up the door to why I'm doing what I'm doing right now. Like, if I hadn't had that experience with having those fibroids grow back with a vengeance, I wouldn't be having this conversation with you right now. And those people, you all who resonate with my message, I wouldn't be speaking about this message if the fibroids didn't come back. And if I didn't have such a hard time actually shrinking the fibroids the second to go around, I wouldn't probably be having this conversation with you. So I'm grateful for that, but like, I'm not, you know, happy about the fibroids. I'm not grateful for the fibroids or anything like that. But God again has been calling me to start fasting again over the last 2 years. And I would do a little short fast here and there. And if you've been following me for any length of time, you will see that I've fasted over the years. But in Isaiah 58, it talks about, is this the fast that I've called you to? And of course, you can read the whole chapter of Isaiah 58 to learn a little bit more about fasting. And I am going to be talking about this coming, you know, this coming up in the future. But it's like, I had to ask myself, okay, what kind of fast has God been calling me to do? And I gotta be honest with you, I would do the fast that I think I wanted to do, or the fast that I felt like I could do on my strength. And it doesn't work like that. If you feel like God's been calling you to a fast and he's been telling you to do something that you think is impossible, then you probably should run in the direction of what he's saying is impossible, because healing comes from you just being obedient to what he's saying to do. So I'm not going to go into too much detail. I'm not going to go into any detail of what he's calling me to right now specifically. That'll come later. I'm going to talk about that in a workshop that is going to be coming up here soon. But some of you, one, you need to learn how to fast. You need support in fasting, and you need healing. And you don't just need healing in your reproductive area. You need healing in every part of your heart. You need healing from that anxiety. You need healing from the fear, the worry, the doubt, the unbelief, all of the traumas that may have happened to you in your life. You need healing from it. And the only place you can get that healing is God. Like I've tried everything, and the peace just doesn't come outside of God. And so that's why I'm doing this workshop. It is going to be held on July 8th, 9th, and 10th in the evening. And so if you want to join the workshop, I'm going to put a link below in the description box. So you can sign up for the workshop. So, and it will be private. It will be done on YouTube. The videos will be done on YouTube, but the only way you'll see the videos is if you are in the workshop. They will not be public videos. So if you haven't signed up for the workshop, you cannot see the videos. I want to repeat that. If you don't sign up for the workshop, which the link is below in the description box, and I'll try and put it up above in the information bar, if you don't sign up, you will not be part of the workshop. And I will also be sending out information via email for support during that time. But each week I'm going to talk about the fasting and praying, so you have more information as we lead up to the date where we're going to be doing the fasting and praying. I don't know that if you fast and pray that the fibroids are going to go away within that time frame that you fast and pray. But the way fasting and praying works is that you will open your heart up to God, so that and pray for the things you need or want, and sit and listen to him and see if he has something to say to you. He'll give you wisdom as to what to do. He will heal you of certain things that are holding you back, holding your heart back, so that the energy in your uterus can free up all the things that you've been holding on to. If you are interested in being a part of the Fasting and Praying Challenge, the 3 days in July, please sign up below and I will send more information to come here shortly. One thing I want to tell you before I go is that when you fast, your body uses the dead denatured tissues, toxic waste, all those types of things as energy, and burns that up during a fast. especially if you really allow yourself to be in a fasted state. And I will go deeper in detail about this as time goes on. But I hope to see you in the fasting and prayer group. And if for some reason you want to join the fasting and prayer challenge and you can't be available during the time that the fasting and prayer challenge is going on, like for example, if we do our sessions in the evening during the work week and you can't be there, that they will be recorded and you'll be able to watch when you do have a convenient time to watch. So I just wanted to say that. But if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, share it with a friend, and don't forget to subscribe. Until next time, y'all, take care.